I knew how it is at an Olympic Games because I've been in Vancouver 2010, and I knew that it's a big thing, and everybody expects, everybody has high expectations, and the media coverage is really big, much bigger than we are used to. So I was this time I was much cooler, much more relaxed, and I knew it's all about my performance and nothing else, not the media, not whatever. Yeah. Yeah, Rock Marguč. I think I had lots of duels with him. And this run is really special because now I crash and I have to ride switch. And normally if that happens, normally you can forget the run and you lose. But somehow I make it back into the course, and luckily it's a really long course. It has been a really long course, and yeah, I closed the gap and managed to win this. I really liked the flat part, where it's all about pushing and let it ride and feel the snow. Yeah, and that's where I made the difference in the end, I think. Good finish. But I remember in semi-final, yeah, I ride against Sean Koshier. He's for sure one of the best riders out there. He's actually leading the World Cup right now. I knew it's all in my hands. I knew I had the speed. Yeah, I'm competitive. I can beat everybody. Still, in alpine snowboarding, every run counts. You cannot do a mistake, you're gone. And yeah, you can never be sure until you finish you pass the last gate. And I knew when I win this one, I'm in the big final, and I have a medal for sure. And I really tried to play my poker face. Don't show any emotions, you know. I was really happy inside, of course, but I did not want it to show. I wanted to keep the warrior attitude a little bit, like, yeah, also because the race is not finished. You have the chance to win a gold medal, and you better stay focused, because next time is 4 years later. So you better try to use the chance. And here in the first run, in the big final, I think we laugh about it when we talk together, me and Vic Wild. We both had a really bad one. But it looks like a good fight, because I lead and he leads again, and then he changes back. In the end, I win it by a little bit, because I did just less mistakes than he did. But yeah, that's how it is when you ride the big final. The slope is always getting worse, bigger bumps. And then, yeah, it's about riding smart, riding a good technique so you're stable. And here I win it by 0.54, which is actually a lot. Yeah, everybody was against me. But everybody was against me, but it kind of felt good, you know? I mean, he's a Russian and we're in Russia. Of course, everybody cheers for him, but it felt good. I like the atmosphere. Nothing bad about cheering for a Russian, yeah. And I really wanted to win, of course. But sometimes, yeah, if I see the riding now, and his run was really strong, sometimes you just have to, yeah, to say, congratulations, good job, man. You deserved it. And when I get second in a World Cup, maybe I need 10 minutes to be happy, but this time I needed 5 seconds. I was maybe a little bit annoyed for the first 5 seconds that I missed the chance to win a gold medal, but then boom, it came automatically. I was so, so happy. Of course, a little bit of tears as well, and yeah, and then just party, yeah, of course. Yeah, one of the best moments for sure. I think one of the best things was that I could see my team members and my coaches from the podium, and I could look them in the eye, and I knew, I felt so grateful, you know, for all these years. I mean, I've been training for this for more than 10 years. I had such a good team, such good people around me, and yeah, I just felt gratitude towards them. Yeah.